Look here, there and yonder, the world is full of wonder. For all the where and why, hows, and the when, what, where's, there's but one place worthy, Achala Bharati. There's but one place worthy, Achala Bharati.
Hello kids, how are you all doing? Hope you are enjoying your holidays. Today, let's see what will happen in Mahabharata story. Arjuna, who is dressed as a Brahmin, walks past the crowd who make fun of him. What happens after that? Come, let us know.
Achala Vismaya Loka, an amazing world of limitless fun. Brought to you by Achala Bharati Trust.
Arjuna walks from the Brahmins group and he walks, and as he walks he's teased again and again from the people around him. Some of them are like, it's okay, this man is so dignified, he has such a dignified walk, we think he's going to pass the examination. Next, he comes to the group of ladies. They were the people who were dressed up and adorned Draupadi, and they were like, almost 1 lakh ladies in that group. This group also included all the ladies or women who came to be the part of the ceremony, not just the ones who came to dress up Draupadi. You can imagine so many of them were there. They were all so busy and self-obsessed. For them, this kind of work can be only for Kshatriyas, not for Brahmins. They are like, who is this and who is this guy? They think he's mad. They're like, this guy is a semi. And others are like, this man's head is filled with mud. What does he think he is? So people are like, man, a big disaster is going to happen. One of them thinks he's semi-mad. The other thinks his head is full of mud. And others are like, what does he think he's doing? Did he think he was called to or invited for a lunch or a party? Some others are like, he looks like he's Devendra from another world. They see him and they are like, look at the way he looks. His personality is so good. He's walking so respectfully. Look at his stature. See the confidence in his face. See the liveliness. I think he's Devendra. He is one among us Brahmins. He will win this competition. Arjuna did not care for any of these talks while walking on the way to lift the bow. You know, many people talk and so many people talk so many things. He just did not care. The Kshatriyas in the crowd are like, what do you think lifting a bow is like? Do you think it is as easy as lifting the deer skin? That is Krishnajina. They use it for sitting like a mat. They sit on it and the kind of divine thing to sit on the Krishnajina. So, the people in the crowd is like, what does he think lifting a bow is? Do you think it's like rolling up the Krishnajina and putting it on your shoulders and walking? Do you think it's that easy? Many others in the crowd are like, what do you think? Is it like a wind blowing pipe? So wherever the priest go, you see, they carry this pipe because they have to perform Homa. And once they set up the fire, they need this pipe to blow the air into the fire to make fire. They are like, you think that this is a wind blowing pipe thing? Do you think that it is as easy as it is? Do you think they are performing a yajna? What do you think? A bow is something like a wind blowing pipe? Others are like, what do you think? That it is a saligrama rock on the banks of the river Gandaki? There are these rocks and they are called saligrama. They call it Ishwara's rock or Shiva's rock. So they ask him, do you think it is a saligrama rock? So many people praising him. So many people teasing and taunting him, he does not care. He keeps moving forward. His aim is to lift the bow. In the crowd, it is difficult to walk through when there are so many people talking like that and taunting and teasing and making comments. He comes to the crowd that is full of women. You see, it is very difficult because it's especially very difficult for Arjuna. So in the crowd, the people, and that too these women, many of them get up after seeing Arjuna walking towards the bow and they run to Draupadi. And this woman who runs and holds on to Draupadi, she holds her hands tightly and says, "Hey, look, that guy who's a Brahmin, he's coming." And Draupadi is like very shy. She will put her head down and think, "I'm now being shamed. My God, I'm so ashamed." But the woman lifts her shin up and says, "Look who is here in front of you." Everyone's thinking is that he loses, okay, because he's not a Kshatriya. So they laugh, ha ha ha. It seems he will lift the bow, aim the fish, and it seems he's going to let go the arrow. So saying, the woman lift Draupadi's chin up and says, "Look what's going to happen." Even though Arjuna has been teased so many times, he still walks among these women and moves forward because nothing touches his mind. Krishna is sitting there. Remember, both Balrama and Krishna are in the crowd watching the ceremony. Krishna asks, "Do you know or heard of Dharmaraya?" And then Krishna turns to Balarama and says, "I did tell you one time that Pandavas are here. They are here, and just look at the face of that man who's walking towards the bow. His face is so bright and lit up." And Krishna turns to Balarama and says, "Brother, do you know who this is?" And then he says, "That man is Arjuna." Balarama can't believe his eyes and can't believe what Krishna just said. He's totally floored and astonished. Balarama tells Krishna, "Krishna, why did they come here? We have heard that the Pandavas are all dead. Even if they were alive, how do you think they will get here? How could they escape?" "They cannot." One question after another, Balarama asks Krishna, and Krishna does not give an answer. He just starts to laugh. He's such a prankster, Krishna. They both are brothers, you know, both Balarama and Krishna. But these two are having a light-hearted conversation between the two of them. Krishna answers, "He is Arjuna. In this world, there is no better archer than Arjuna." Children, you all must remember what Lakshya means. It means aim. If anyone asks you all what Lakshya means, it means aim. You will say your aim is passing the examination, writing well, reading well, okay, and then going to the next grade and then finding a job, etc., etc. That is it. If you are ready to go somewhere and someone asks, "Where are you going?" you will say, "I'm going to the railway station, I'm going to by the rail, and then, you know, from there I'm going somewhere to that place, etc." That's called Lakshya. What is Arjuna's Lakshya? Lifting the bow, aiming the fish and killing the fish. And then there is the public, the people for whom, you know, all the people who are there, they are happy whoever wins, they don't care. Whoever wins, you see, that person is going to be lucky. That's what they think. They are just happy and Arjuna is just walking past them and he is not concerned. And then he bows to everybody and then goes and stands where the bow is. He lifts the bow and shows everybody. Okay, Jarasandha did not lift it. Karna could not. Okay, but this Arjuna lifts the bow like a flower. After that he thinks, "I thought the bow would be very heavy, but it is really not that heavy at all." So he is like, "Why did the kings get so afraid to lift it? Why didn't they not be able to lift it?" Arjuna is a brave soldier, but he is still very perplexed as to why he could and none of the people before could not lift the bow. He always thought that there were people who were much more stronger than him, but it was not like that. He lifted the bow like a flower and then people in the audience are surprised. He has to aim the fish on top by looking at the reflection in the oil below, and he does it all so easily. Like it is written about him that his walk was so dignified that he lifts the bow and aims the fish and hits it too. No one has done that before. So his aim was so accurate that the arrow struck the fish. And the arrow struck there and did not fall down. You see, if Sachin Tendulkar or Kohli, if they hit a sixer, how the crowd cheers them, how they scream. Have you all listened to it? When the school bell rings, all the children let out a sound, ooh, like that. Such a sound. No one else can do it. Only children can do it. Okay? Cricket, football games and kabaddi, and also hear the spectators give off that sound. That sound is called a thrill. Kind of like it's come out because people are so happy, being extremely happy and excited at the same time. There were three groups altogether, the Brahmins group, the Kshatriyas groups and the women's group. And they all wanted to see this poor guy can lift the bow. When you go to see the cricket match, you see if somebody hits a sixer or a century, the crowd, the cheer in the crowd, the voice, you know, it's like, ah, like that. Have you heard it? The Brahmins cheered like that. They said, Draupadi, she is now stuck with the Brahmins. The Brahmins have got her. Draupadi got caught by the Brahmins. They shout. The Brahmins group is happy and elated at the same time. The women's group who had teased and taunted Arjuna are now so surprised and like, you see, they are like waves of ocean. They rise and they cheered when Arjuna accomplished the feat. If one woman cheers, then it is one thing. But if thousands of them cheer and they are happy, you can just imagine how it sounds. What will the Kshatriyas think? The poet describes how the Brahmins felt. And the women are like ocean, and Kshatriyas, they were saying, we could not. How can a Brahmin lift the bow? And now they are so surprised. They put their finger in the nose. What does it mean when somebody puts finger in the nose? That means they are very surprised. When surprised, the fingers go into the nose, eyes become big and you give out a shout, oh! So the Rajas, the kings who were Kshatriyas, put their finger in the nose. They were like, oh my God, really? How did he aim and hit the target? None of us could do it. They were all surprised. And at the same time, they were very sorrowful too. They are not happy that the Kshatriyas could not do it. The poor Brahmin came and lifted the bow and then aimed the fish. So saying, they are very sad. They become very heavy-hearted. None of us could win the competition is one thinking. And the Kshatriyas are like, man, this guy, a Brahmin, accomplished this feat. And that's a very sad thing for them. The Brahmins, you see, they all were happy. They all screamed, ah! The ocean of women in the audience also swelled. Like the waves swell in the ocean. You should have seen in cinemas how the waves come roaring towards the rock and then they hit with a splash. The kings, on the other hand, could not react. They were stunned. When Arjuna walked past them, they taunted him. But now they have no voice. They're all heavy-hearted. So much commotion among the Brahmins, Kshatriyas, the women. But the Kauravas think that there is something wrong. There must be cheating. Whether it is a Brahmin or anyone else. It's like, if they were capable to hit the target, well, the Kauravas are like very doubtful. They turn towards their people around and then turn towards their friend and say, cheating. These people, they only have to hear the word cheating and these friends become all furious. They say the main intention of the king is to make fun of the Kshatriyas because Kshatriyas failed in this test. Such a bad intention. For them, it is like they made the Kshatriyas look no good and let the Brahmins win. Look at the intention of the king. This was a plan made to shame us. They say and stand by this statement. You see, the American president, when he loses the election, the results are telecasted on TV and everything. But still, the guy named Trump says there is some kind of cheating in the elections. He screams foul.
What can be done? Nothing. We have to listen to this type of screaming. Just like the Kshatriyas are being shamed because one Brahmin has now claimed to have won the competition. Drupada has cheated. Drushtadyumna has cheated. For that we have to protest. That's what they say. The protest started from here. The Kauravas make arrangements for the war. What kind of bad situation is this? All the bad things have happened. So saying they are about to start a war. But the story is, they do not know that this man is Arjuna. Along with Arjuna, Bhima was also there in the Pandavas group. Bhima, Nakula, Sahadeva, all of them were there. Dharmaraya also was present. In waging a war, they are no less compared to anyone. They are all together, all the five along with Arjuna. They defeat the kings. The kings run away to save their lives. I will continue the story in the next part.
Children, this episode teaches us that we can win any challenge with determination. Let us know your feedback in the comment section. Bye!